Good evening. I am the main anchor of the Toyota Times Athletes Now. Morita Kyonosuke is my name, Kozuka Takahiko, Nagasaki Nozomi, and Toyoda Akio. Now, this is the 13th day. We are about to see the closing ceremony. We have been introducing to you 66 para athletes out of 134 GGTAs in 47 countries and regions. We have been trying to share with you how they have been performing to know about the Paralympics and enjoy and send them the support. And this is the last night, and we also received many messages of thanks. Hello. This is Ricardino, and I'm here at the Tokyo Games. Thank you very much for your support. We're together. On behalf of the team, I'd like to extend my appreciation to the Toyota family. And thank you very much for supporting me all the way up to Tokyo and during the Paralympic Games. Toyota amigos, this is Valencia. I have just finished the javelin competition, and as you may know, we have been in an extremely challenging situation, and I could not reach the gold, although we had to concentrate extremely for the game. But at least I have achieved the goal over 5 years to be here. And I will continue my career as an athlete, and thank you very much for your support. This is Eva Moral. Thank you very much for your support. And I won bronze medal here in Tokyo. Thank you very much.
Jared Wallace here. Just wanted to say thank you for all of your support as I run at the Paralympic Games in Japan this year. We won a bronze medal in the 200, and I'm so excited to be here. Again, thank you for all your support. Go Team USA and go Team Toyota.
Hello, Suzuki Tomoki. I have just finished my last race, that is a marathon, at the Tokyo Paralympic Games. Thank you very much for your support. And your support sent me an energy to finish my race. To the development team as well, thank you very much for your support for Paralympic Games in Paris. Hope that you would continue to support me. Once again, thank you very much. To members of Toyota family, thank you very much. I won gold medal here in Tokyo 2020, and I came to know that the Vio of Italy was also a member of the Toyota family. I thought there was the relationship with between us, and because of that, we are friends at the same time, the good rivals. Once again, to Toyota family members, thank you very much, and I love you. Muraoka Momoka, I competed in 100 meters, and thank you very much for your support. To aim for the participation in the Games 2.5 years ago, I decided to start my challenge from alpine skiing. During that time, I worried. Sometimes it was extremely hard and demanding, challenging. Yet, at the same time, I really enjoyed their experience up to Tokyo Paralympic Games. Starting fall, I will restart my activity as an alpine skier. Hope that you would continue to cheer for me for Beijing Games. But once again, to all the friends, thank you very much for your support. Momoka, well done. I believe you are the number one athlete in the world, and you make me proud. Now, you know that the snow mountain is waiting for us, so let's move forward toward Beijing Games. And also, I'd like to remind you that the Beijing athletes, the winter athletes, GGTAs, are aiming for Beijing, so send us your support. Well, we just heard from Morioka and Marie. What can you say, Mr. Yokoda? Yes, they all start their comments with their appreciation. And also, GGTAs have competed with each other as a rival. Many bonds and relationships were born. And the two-way athletes who compete both in summer and winter, was very impressive. The winter is just around the corner, and therefore only 4 months from now, they will compete once again in Beijing. Just 4 months, 4 months from now? Yes, that will be in February, so 4 months from now, really. Well, this time, I received messages from many athletes. And today, for the first time, for Paralympic version, we have a live streaming with the Miki-san, who was the wheelchair tennis player representing Japan. He was introduced in the program as well. Well, this is your third Paralympic Games, and the good work. Thank you for your support. Today we have Mr. Yokoda, Mr. Toyoda with us. So if you can give us your report. Well, good evening, my dad or father. We received a very encouraging remarks, the messages from father, and therefore I strive for the game with best of my energy, and the result was best the top 16 in the singles, and the finished the game in the second round and the doubles. But the when I became the member of the Toyota family, ever since I received many support from you, that was really encouraging, and I'm here to stand. I realize I grew thanks to you, with standing here with my feet, and I really felt that there was such a close support from you. Thank you very much. What a wonderful young man. Yes, he is really admirable young the man. I'm a little bit nervous. He has grown up, I would say. Well, this time at the Paralympic Games, which took place here in Tokyo. Now, what is impression? Because it is taking place in my home country, compared to Rio, London, Paralympic Games, I would say that I received a strong energy, encouragement, support from the people in Japan. Miki-san, the seat that was improved together with the development team of Toyota, what was your impression? Was amazing. But also, I found out the things to be improved. So I'd like to make some order or request for improvement. Yes, I visited Mr. Miki and heard about the improved seat, and therefore I was very much interested in the impression that he had. If you have a problem, you should say that candidly. I would say that just fit me for the competition that I just competed. Miki-san, we shared with the audience photos that you took. It was amazing. Where is it? I think it's Turin in Italy. No one is walking. Is it early in the morning or in the evening? Actually, in the evening. The signal turned to red. Went to shoot a photo, and then other people helped me and cooperated with me. Maybe because I was in a wheelchair, the pedestrians there just to control the traffic to help me finish my photo shooting. A wonderful, amazing story. And are you a semi-professional photographer, or is it just your hobby? Well, I'm an amateur. This is just my hobby. Now that you're interested in photos, and in fact, I would say that I have a very good sense in photos. I wanted to compete with you, but I decided to give up after seeing this picture. And no comment. Shall we introduce other photos as well? This is again Chilling. What do you take into account when you take a picture? I would say that, for instance, the where to place people, the horizon. For instance, this is in winter, therefore, I wanted to reproduce transparency as much as I can. And I realized that there is the copyright, meaning that this should not be copied without permission. Because there was a case, actually, was used without permission. But I would say he is already qualified as a professional. So this is another the anecdote that we introduced in this program. And also during the games, you also sent us pictures. Here it is. De La Penta of the Spain, another GTTA. So you feel the bond or relationship with fellow GTTAs. Yes, I would say it's quite strong. And in fact, he say hello to me, and whether it is inside the court or outside, and also during for the practice, he helped us. And also, your close friend of Fernandez of Argentina. Yes. Yes, we enjoy TV games, online game friends, as I understand. So they're connected all over the world. Yes. Sometimes we play in the venue. I understand that you spend a lot of time for playing games. I would say I'm not the number one. And I understand that there you also played games with the staff who are here today. And the studio, yes. The friends in Toyota also invited me for playing games. And you have been aiming for playing at the Paralympic Games for 5 years, and after finishing the games, what can you say? I want to play tennis. I would say I strongly regret the result. I would say this may be the games that I regret most. Because of the characteristics of the event, that is tennis, that we are touring all around the year, and therefore we have to the restart for the next games. But there was a final yesterday. I was watching that game. I really wished I could have been there in that court for the final. So I would say more than ever, I really want to make use of what I learned this time. So that's another reason why you made a request for improvement of the seat. Yes. If this part of the seat is improved even further, then I could play even better. Okay, then I have to go visit him and interview him. In fact, every time you interview athletes, they're changing all the time. And as we received a message of support from the Toyota friends, and therefore, please say hello to them. Yes. To those of you who are watching Toyota Times athletes, I am Miki. For 13 days, you've been watching the Paralympic Games, and what is your reaction? Personally, as I said earlier, the result was not what aimed for, but I would say that the GTTA athletes were there with as much hot energy as the Olympian athletes. They were there doing their best in various venues, and in fact, this is not the end the future games, including Paris. We hope that what we have done here would become a legacy for the future. Once again, thank you very much for your support in the past 13 days. Yeah, Miki-san, we received many messages hoping for your best in the future. Thank you. I'm happy to hear that. Thank you.
Okay, then yesterday and today's GTTA result. It's the final day to share with you the results. GTTA and GTTA countries are shown in red. Men's long jump, T20. Malaysia Romley, gold medal, congratulations. He injured his left leg in the final, so he was on a wheelchair at the victory ceremony. With a medal, there were moments, as we can see in the picture, he was in tears. Congratulations again. Next, men's shot put. Tyron Pillay from South Africa, final 8th. Thank you for being on our program. Men's 200 meter T64, Wallace, USA. Sato-san said he's confident that he will gain a medal, and he did. Bronze medal in his first Paralympic. And next, men's marathon T54 to GTTA participated. Suzuki Tomoki of Japan, final 7th. For Suzuki, including relay, it was his 4th event, so he was totally tired out. However, he said that he could understand the level of the Paralympics. He would like to take time and continue training for the coming 3 years. And Monahan of Ireland, 12th. Next, para badminton. It's the first event in Tokyo Paralympic. Fujihara of Japan, singles SL3 for the bronze medal match, lost. However, in mixed doubles, he won in the bronze medal match. Congratulations on bronze medal. This is a new event from Tokyo, so I'm sure that people are getting more and more interested in para badminton. And next, we had a special feature, football five-a-side. Alves from Brazil. Final against Argentina, 1-2-0 gold medal. Congratulations. Yes, for Brazil team, it's the 5 consecutive gold, and for Alves, it's his 4th consecutive gold. In the end, Alves kept the ball and gained the gold medal. Congratulations. Finally, wheelchair basketball men's final. Sergio, USA against Japan, won a gold medal. Congratulations. Sergio scored 28 points out of all 64 points. Wow, almost half. Yes, we can see his proud face. Those were the results. Thank you very much for all the athletes. Today, Toyotatimes athletes now. Olympics 17 days, Paralympics 13 days, so 30 days total. It is our 30th day. President Toyoda is with us, so we would like to take a look back at our 30 days. President, this time's Tokyo Olympics, Paralympics, before starting, are we really going to do it? Will there be spectators? There were many things. Then they decided to start. What do you feel, President? As you said, are we really going to hold it? Will we have spectators? What's the situation of COVID-19? There were many questions, but amidst the situation, COVID is continuing, and there was the dedicated support continuously from medical members, and also there was the perseverance and sacrifice of restaurants and event-related people, and it's all continuing. I've always been saying, even inside my company, it's important to have a perspective of you. But I had a question in my mind when I say you, who is the you in this type of environment? And what should my standpoint be? I did have a question in my mind. I had to ask myself. However, I decided that I should come back to the starting point when I decided to become the Olympic Paralympic sponsor as Toyota. One was that the power of sports to never give up and to support each other, help each other, what we can learn and gain from sport. I think there is the power that we have, that we can foster talents, human development through sports. So let's just purely support athletes. I think that is the true starting point, and that led to Toyotatimes athletes now. And when we think about it, throughout the world, there are so many Olympic, Paralympic athletes all over the world. I was surprised, to be honest. And I also said, our company is going to become a mobility company. When we say so, we say that we say freedom of mobility for all. That is one of our slogans. And especially for Paralympic, how we are able to provide mobility to people and how we can move people, not just physically, but also emotionally. And Olympic and Paralympic, summer and winter, it's the delivery date will be once every 2 years. So let's make that a target, and it will be a place of verification and a target that we can aim to deliver our products and improve our products. It's sort of like a model change that we would have for our vehicles. I think that we can continue this improvement cycle in this two-year cycle. So those were the two perspectives I decided to hold as you. So number one is athletes support, and that is equal to Toyotatimes athletes now. Yes. And in Olympic, Paralympic, I think for Toyota, there were two gambas. Number one is the gamba where the athletes compete. And number two, anywhere the athletes are, everywhere, I think there are Toyota products. For example, the transportation of athletes and also the javelin throw. FSR, yes, to transport, to help them, and also the equipment, like Suzuki-san, and also Miki-san's, his wheelchair, the seat. I think there were many equipments that we could provide. And for the mobility in Athletes Village, there was the e-pallet. That was also one of our equipment. And to operate those, to support and operate, that is another gemba for us. Many of our employees were involved in the operation. So those are the two gemba that Toyota had in Olympic and Paralympic this time. So regarding e-pallet you just mentioned, there was a collision with an athlete. And I think there were difficulties. Well, may I ask about that too? Yes, I decided to come to this program so that I can explain in my words to you. And you did explain to us what happened. And I did announce that e-pallet did resume its operation in Athletes Village. But what was actually happening? I think there are things which are not clear yet. What happened was, in the athlete's village, there are various buildings, and it is connected by a road. And whenever there's a road, there will be an intersection and also the zebra crossing where pedestrians walk, vehicles, humans, and e-pallets. Multiple things intertwine and move around. If it's an ordinary road, there will be a traffic light. And if it's green, you can cross for the pedestrian's traffic signal. And if it's red, cars will stop. And in the intersection, we would easily know which one should stop. But at an athlete village, there were no traffic lights. So at a place without traffic light, and people in the athlete village from all over the world. They have their own rules in their country. So I think that was the situation at the athlete village. However, even at this type of environment, the athlete there was collided by e-pallet and he decided not to participate in the competition. I want to express my sincere apology to the athlete. However, one thing is that he was not severely injured. That is one grateful thing. The road is constituted by the vehicle, pedestrian, and guide who takes the role of the traffic light. So there are three parties on the road at that time. When there was the collision, what I thought was good was that the three parties, they did not blame each other. Rather, they tried to find out what really happened. They cooperated in order to find out the true cause, to make clear what actually happened and why this incident happened. They didn't say it wasn't my fault and so. They did not blame each other, but tried to really find out what happened. And based on those facts, we were able to take countermeasures. Without blaming anyone, we improved the system and we were able to resume operation. Especially para athletes, they tend to have huge luggages. That is why when we decided to resume, many athletes did express their appreciation that it will ease their mobility. However, SNS, they are useful, but at the same time, as I mentioned, this time it was the responsibility of the system. It was not any individual's responsibility. It's not anyone's fault. However, on SNS, because there are people who don't know the reasons, there were hurting comments, and there were comments trying to make it someone's responsibility. That is why there are members hurt with these kinds of SNS comments. However, this time it was because of the system itself. That is why I hope the viewers will understand what happened, and I hope that we can create safety together. Once again, safe and secure traffic flow is created by a trinity of vehicles, pedestrian, and infrastructure. That is what I think. And this time, we took the role as guides, which means we became the traffic signals. Until now, we were developing vehicles, so we had the perspective of vehicles and pedestrians. We never thought we would take the role of a traffic light. I did say Trinity, but from the perspective of traffic signals, what is the safe flow, the movement of vehicles? What is the safe movement of pedestrians? I think we were able to experience at the Gemba, and I believe this was a good experience for future safety.
So there were some findings because there were no traffic lights there. Yes. When that happened, we thought that maybe you would give up the autonomous driving. And in fact, that was also expressed by some people as concerns. But rather than giving it up, we want to continue a challenge. And fortunately, the athlete that was involved in that accident, he was not severely injured. He had prepared for the games, and yet he could not advance to the competition in Tokyo about 3 years from now. I hope that he will be there in Paris for a competition. We investigated and the findings, the facts about what happened here, and for development of technology to provide freedom of mobility to all, I am sure that our experience was quite useful. So they would say that with a 15, that is 15% of the people all around the globe have one way or another, there's handicaps and they are on the street, and therefore this case helped us to stretch our imagination, thoughts, and when we develop Woven City, I'm sure that this experience would be greatly utilized, and I think that is the best way to make use of the experience that we had this time. In fact, I encountered many people, and yet we were only exposed to news, and without visiting Genji and Genbutsu, you could not make such findings. And so, in your case, you visited the Paralympian village. Yes. Actually, before the games started, at the time of the opening ceremony, I visited the operators. And from that day, over a month or so, more than 60 peers, the friends, they worked in three shifts around the clock. And I personally faced them and asked them to ensure safety at all costs, and despite that, that accident was experienced, and therefore I would say that a total of five times I visited the Paralympic village, although I did not go to see any games or the events at all, but I visited the Paralympian village and that spot again and again. That is based upon the information that I gained personally, without blaming anyone. We wanted to make sure that the operation could be resumed for the convenience of users. Yet, there are those people who are not that conscionable, but I would say that there are those people involved here. They have friends and families, and even when they are hurt by such unconscionable comments, I'm sure that eventually their damages would be cured. Well, you visited spots and Paralympian village again and again, despite your busy schedule. And also, despite your schedule, another Genba to support athletes, that is this program, you came to show up for this program, and if you can share with us your impression about the program. Yes, I would say that it started from the motivation to send our support to the Olympic athletes, and now I was amazed to see that there are 234 GTTAs, and therefore, so over a month, there are athletes who are friends that we could feature in our programs. So I would say that it was the in-house production, that is Mr. Toyoda and us. That's right. And in fact, the programs produced within the organization together with the anchors and reporters. And also, we shed more light on minor sports that people were not familiar with, and yet this was a great opportunity to learn about the rules. Yeah, for instance, club throw. In fact, there were so many new information that I gained this time. This is also produced by us, by the 3D printer. And also, Mini Mr. Toyota that was produced within the organization. And also, since we are a car manufacturer, the relationship with the cars, the vehicles that were highlighted, for instance, Yaris was used as the unit. And also cars that those athletes drive. And comparison with the motorsport, for instance, we received the message from Latvala-san. And also, DMG, ever since Toyota Gazoo Racing, We have been involved in the development support for Jobert, and that was also featured in this program. Yes, on the very first day, you mentioned about the affinity between the Paralympic Games and the motorsport, and then almost every day, the relationship between the two and affinity between the two was mentioned. And then came the wheelchair rugby for changing a wheel. That was exactly like changing a wheel for the racing car. And I also participated by way of sending comments. You know, it was like the gymnastics meeting that I am cheering the athletes as a spectator. So women's support, the softball, for instance, I love to watch games, and every time there will be the former coaches and managers who would sit next to me and to explain about the rules and the interesting part of the games. And at the same time, they deviate from the main game and talk about something else. And that's another way of enjoying sport. Yes. And in fact, we realized that the spectators of this program, I would say, they also enjoyed. You found out many names. And in fact, when the question was raised by you, then the answer, a reply came back immediately. And also, I felt their presence very close. And then finally, the actual Paralympian, the Tyrone Pile, who also sent his comment when he was featured. Yes, he was using his Instagram, and I was using the YouTube, and they were connected here. And Nagasaki-san was involved in the starting off that kind of involvement by him. And while supporting those athletes at the same time, they also explained about what happened about e-Palant. And the Toyota Times, that is viewed as owned media, and therefore, the people tend to take it as something where we would just introduce our theory, but we wanted to reflect and introduce a real story at the best timing. So even when some stories or information that are against us, yet if that is information that people are interested in, we wanted to share that information with the rest of the world, and I think that was one of the missions of this Toyota Times. And through this program, focusing on athletes, yet we achieved that as well. And in fact, you explained everything, and that was quite clear. And in fact, that is based upon your experience of the visiting the actual spot or place where that accident took place. So what happens from now? The after Olympic and Paralympic Games, as we started this program, and Winter Games, they are just around the corner, and 3 years from now, there will be another Summer Games, so we want to maintain this program. Because the athletes within a company, they are also striving. Yes, we are involved in those games as well as motorsports. And motorsports, in fact, that is a sport, the one of the event, and you are a driver yourself, right? Yes. So even on a weekly basis, there will be a lot of information that we can cover. So hope that we can keep this kind of program. And also, as we did this time, those people who are supporting athletes, and in the case of the motorsports, there are products involved, that is the development of cars, vehicles, and the maintenance, the involving mechanics.
The people who were involved in operation, maybe we could focus even more. Yeah, so in Toyota Times Athletes Now, the people who were supporting the athletes, we could focus on that too, that each and every story, yes. When we talk about the athletic club, we tend to look at the players in the matches, but there are people in the bench and also people keeping track of the score. Yes, I think so. I think There are GTTA members who were not in Tokyo, however, they are continuing their athletes' mission, for example, trying to extend the sport in his or her country. Yes, I also felt that doing the interview, there are so many places I need to visit in Toyota. So I think I want to continue this kind of interview, and there are lots of things I still want to share with everyone. Toyotatimes Athletes Now. This was a program to communicate sports, and I want to continue this. Well, we're coming to the end of our program. Out of 30 programs, it's our 30th day. And of course, this song. Thanks to this song, we were able to continue our support of our athletes. Finally, present, please. Tokyo 2020, Tokyo Summer, is coming to its final chapter, but our challenge towards the impossible, start your impossible, this journey has just begun. Along with the rhythm of Tokyo Summer, not just saying it was good, fun, moved, but I hope with this lyric, start your impossible from Tokyo Summer 2021.
A huge thank you to the Toyota family for your ongoing support over many, many years. We truly could not do this without you guys.
Rasaannya setelah bertanding di Paralympic Tokyo yang pasti sangat bahagia karena kembali berhasil.
再次感谢丰田大家族的支持，爱你们哟！
今大会は本当に多くの方にこうした難しい状況の中支えていただき、プレーすることができ、感謝の気持ちでいっぱいです。
I'm a proud member of Toyota family for more than two years.
Quería agradecer el apoyo de Toyota en
Thanks
este último
to
members
tiempo, of Toyota,
porque fue de gran ayuda para poder clasificar
y
participar en los Juegos Paralímpicos de Tokio
2020.
A la gente de Toyota por el apoyo en el proceso Camino a Tokio y por el aguante durante estas semanas en los Paralímpicos. Un saludo grande y por muchos años más.
Bueno, no me queda más sino decirles muchas gracias por el apoyo y demás.
Ya saben cómo.
In Tokyo,
I was able to gain my bronze medal yesterday.
We won a bronze medal in the 200, and I'm so excited to be here. Again, thank you for all your support. Go Team USA and go Team Toyota.
本当に皆さん応援ありがとうございました。皆さんの応援を力に変えて最後まで頑張ることができました。
本当に今回の東京パラリンピック応援ありがとうございました。
Some days that I couldn't show myself, oh, with loneliness and